Hi and welcome back, guys. There's something I forgot to mention in the in my last video.
Is that
I'm going to proceed with this game in solo style. I'm doing this because for Monster Hunter, I find that solo is a lot more challenging than group play because. Well, basically, you have the full attention of the monster you're trying to fight all the time. So, it is more fun that way, if that's your kind of thing. So, what I'll be doing is basically fight everything solo until the point that maybe when I can't proceed on or the bosses gets too hard, then I'll probably join some group play. Also, another thing I need to mention is that for all my future videos, I'll be using mostly Greatsword. The research commission's leads. Later on, maybe
the ones they deem worth our attention become quests.
Reason for this is because a lot of monsters are mostly melee based, and then but later on there's some monster that fly around a lot, so it's a lot more convenient to use bow. And also, in my future videos, I'll try to edit out all the scenes in town just to keep the video interesting. Maybe I'll include some clips of it if I find something interesting. And that's it. Let's dive straight to our first mission.
Alright, this is our first job. Let's do a quick review of quest rules. Rule number one, complete the objective to complete the quest. Easy, right? Each quest has an objective. You can't consider the quest done until you complete that objective. Our current objective is to eliminate a specified number of Jagras. Let's check the map. We ran into some Jagras on the way to base. The small monsters, remember? I think we saw them somewhere around here. Want to check it out? Rule number two, use the supply box. The commission supplies us with a loadout of... They're in the supply box over there. Have a look and decide what you should take along.
So, this is our first mission.
Hey, partner!
The objective is to kill some roadkills. This is very easy. One thing I need to mention is if you planning on buying this game, I highly suggest you buy a controller. I have a PS4 controller just for this game, and the whole game,
Wanna get going?
The movements, combat, are built around this control scheme. So, if you don't have a controller, I'll highly recommend you to go get one just for this game. Mouse and keyboard is highly not recommended. And the controller also have this vibration features, which
ready
is
your weapon
very,
before
very
attacking.
Nice.
Keep in mind that what you're able to do depends on whether or not your weapon is strong.
Of the controller really does add a lot of immersion to the
generally
game.
Want to keep your weapon sheathed.
And speaking of immersion, let me just pause the video right here. Now, in the earlier versions of Monster Hunter, when you land a hit like that, the monster will spill a lot of blood, like a fountain. For example, like in Kill Bill, in the scene where Beatrix cut off the French girl's arm in the restaurant scene. Yeah, that kind of fountain. It really adds a lot of excitement to the thrill of the hunt. But now, due to the media censorship and ratings, I think Capcom are forced to take this away. which is also a reason why I've been waiting for the PC release, hoping that someone will add a mod to return back that feature. Yeah.
The great sword is a powerful close range weapon. Though attacks leave you wide open, the payoff is well worth it. Hey! You can use that as slinger ammo. Great for getting a monster's attention or creating a distraction. You can gather honey and mix it with a potion to make mega potions. Over here! Over here!
A pack of Jagras! Those are the monsters we're after!
Let's see how you hold up when you're on your own.
Here are the targets. They're very, very easy to kill. So I'll just leave you to it. Enjoy. So this is the strong kind of greatsword. It has a wide range attack. It covers a quite a big area. And for single target, we have a front slash and a uppercut. It's something like a flexible, as in the sense that they have area damage in a single target. Yeah.
Over here.
A big part of Monster Hunter is that you have to forage the forest or the area to gather the materials to make whatever you want. It gives a very raw feeling. Yeah.
Whoops. Use whatever you can.
So that concludes the first mission. I think I'm gonna edit out the rest of the running around and jump straight to the second mission.
Of Kestadon. Recently, their numbers have been getting out of hand.
Wanna get going?
Okay, so that was a very beautiful sunset.
We're
and
on the hunt.
This is the second mission. The objective is to cull some other roadkill critters. So, here goes.
Those, my friend, are Kestadon. Let's see you take him out on your own. Huh. Be careful. Thank you. Let's look for another group. The Castodon are the least of your worries. There are a lot bigger monsters lurking in this forest. Be careful. The endemic life around here can come in handy during a hunt. Try to learn as much as you can about them. Over here! Over here! Over here!
Sorry for the excessive running around. I'm currently trying to locate a mining point that gives the Earth Crystal. In order to upgrade my sword. In this next fight, I forgot to sharpen my great sword, so as a consequence, it bounces a lot and cost me some health points. Also, if you forgot to sharpen your sword, it will do a lot less damage.
That wraps up our work here. Wait. Hey, come here! Think I found something. Here. Hmm. Look at those Kestodon. Something's up with them. Now!
Partner, new assignment incoming. Take down that Great Jagras. If you're not ready, you can return to base and take on the Great Jagras quest later.
Want to get going? If you need to call your friends for help, go to the menu and select SOS Flare to signal them. And you're going to need friends when you go up against some of the tougher monsters. In order for the scout flies to better track a target monster, we need to keep finding traces of it. Like footprints, for example. Good. You're turning up a lot of clues. Okay. We've tracked the Great Jagras enough for the scout flies to lead us to it. You're less likely to lose sight of a monster if you use the focus camera.
Here I was expecting it to turn around and get the full force of the slash, but it didn't happen.
Okay, the monster's tired. Now's your chance to deal some serious damage. Monsters are running away. Use the scout flies as a guide and they'll lead you right to them. Bright moss can be used as slinger ammo. Launch it at walls to eliminate dark areas, like the inside of a cave, for example. mobilized. Now's your chance. Whetstone. Look, the monster's almost done for. Chances are it'll retreat to its nest to recuperate.
I think we got a lead.
Maybe. Let's check it out. Well, you were right. There's our mark. Something's got him agitated. Look over there. What in the heck is that? I've never seen anything like it.
You think it's from Zora Magdaros?
I'd like to find out. But we better report back first. All right?
Well, that concludes the second mission. I'll see if we can squeeze in the third mission into this video. If not, I'll be putting it on the next episode. See you guys. So this is mission 3. I think I'm going to make each one of my following videos like 1 hour long. This this mission's objective is two of those great Jenga. So enjoy.
Are you okay? The scout flies have found something. Go get a closer look. Great! The scout flies have locked on to the scent of the monster. Be on the lookout for more tracks or traces. The scout flies have picked up the monster's trail. We'll be on the target before long. Hope you're ready. Are fighting each other? Maybe we can use this to our advantage. monster's really mad now. Be ready for some vicious attacks.
Dodge their attacks. Don't forget you can guard too. That's a piercing pot, a powerful type of slinger ammo. That's able to pierce the thick shell of monsters.
After this fight, I think I've lost my way in the forest. So I'll just skip the video straight to the part where I'm about to find him.
this is the end of third mission, and the time is 47, almost 48 minutes now. So I don't think I can fit in another mission here. So this will be the end of this episode. Okay, see you guys.